Welcome to the Office Productivity Applications class. It's a long word, long name, but let me go over some of the important information from the syllabus. Now the syllabus, you can read it for yourself. I'm not going to read it to you, but I just want to emphasize some of the points. We're going to be learning about three main things that you need to do for academic and business work. That's word processing with Microsoft Word, spreadsheets with Microsoft Excel, and presentations, both traditional presentations using PowerPoint and video presentations. Now we're learning just about Microsoft Office because that is what we use at the school. It's what you need to use for your assignments, and so that's why we're focusing on that. There are other good Office productivity app suites like Google and Apple, but we have standardized here on Microsoft, so that's why we have you do all your work in Microsoft. Well, let me tell you a little bit about how this class is going to be conducted. This is an online class. All of the assignments and instructions are in Schoology. Okay, you'll learn how to do that, but that's where everything is going to be done. You're going to have a number of projects to complete. In word processing, in Excel, in presentations, you'll have projects. And you're also going to have a pace chart that will give you due dates to keep you on track. You can use a number of resources. There are a few textbooks in the Media Center. There are online videos in Schoology to explain how to do things. You can go up to Google and search. There are a lot of ways that you can find help. You can also check with me. I'll be checking in with you regularly, and you can ask me for help as well. And you will be submitting all your assignments through Schoology. Now, because it's online, you have to use your time well. So be sure you're doing that. Now, let's talk about grading. Okay, grading. Grading in this class is going to be a little bit different than in other classes. Instead of you getting a grade on each assignment, just averaging all those together, you're going to earn points for each assignment, for each project, for each quiz, those things. You have here in the syllabus the number of points that each one is worth. But as you get points, you see that in the first quarter there are 500 possible points, there are 350 possible points in the second quarter. And I've got a chart here that shows you at the end of the quarter, if you've earned a certain number of points, what your grade is going to be, and you'll get a letter grade on your report card. In Schoology, you'll be able to see how many points you've earned, so you can see what you still have to do. I'm also going to post a leaderboard in Schoology, showing how many points you have earned so that the rest of the class, this is going to be kind of a competition. You can see who can earn the most points in the quarter. So you're going to want to stay on top of that. In fact, if you want to earn more points, here's something else that's different from other classes. When you turn in a project and you get a grade on it, in other classes, that grade just sticks. You get a C on an assignment, that C stays there. That's not the case in this course. You can redo any of your assignments up until the last day of the quarter and bring your grade up. So, if you do a project, let's say you do a word processing project and it's worth 25 points and you get 15 out of the 25 points. I'm going to tell you in Schoology, I will list, here's what you did wrong, here's what you missed on this project. You can fix that. You can make all the corrections, you can resubmit it, and then you'll get the 25 points. The 15 points just disappears, you'll get all 25 points. If you still have errors on it the second time around, maybe you just get 20 points. You can do it again. You can do it as many times as you want to get more points. That means there's no reason for any of you to get anything less than an A+ in this class, because you can keep doing your assignments until you get them perfect. So you can redo your assignments as often as you need to, as often as you want to pull your grade up. Now, what about late assignments? This also is different from other classes. Okay, I'm not going to penalize you directly for a late assignment. If you turn in an assignment late, you don't lose points on that assignment. Instead, you're going to be able to earn points at the end of the quarter for being ahead of pace. At the end of each week, I'm going to count up how many assignments you are ahead of the pace chart, and you'll get one bonus point for each assignment, with a maximum of 4 points each week. At the end of the quarter, I'll add up all those points and I'll add them to your total points for the quarter, which will kind of be an extra credit. If you're behind the pace chart, I'm going to count up how many assignments you're behind each week. You'll lose 2 points for each one that you're behind, and you can lose a maximum of 8 points each week. And in your syllabus, I have this example to show you with Johnny and Billy what happens. So the point is that as you stay ahead of your pace chart, you stay ahead of it, you earn bonus points. If you stay right with it, if you stay right on the pace and you're turning in the assignments right when they're due, you get no extra points, but you don't lose any. Okay, that's fine. You can still get 100, you can still get an A plus on everything. You'll just get bonus points if you get ahead of schedule. So work to be ahead of schedule, and then you will be able to get a lot of bonus points. When you're absent, you're still expected to do your assignments. After all, everything is in Schoology. And the assignments are due every Friday at 11:59 p.m. So if you're absent, like on Tuesday, you still have to turn the assignment in Friday. There are a couple of examples there that I explain about when there might be an exception. But generally, the due dates are firm, so just follow the pace chart. Speaking of the pace chart, here is your pace chart, and this also is in your Schoology course. You notice that you have assignments due here on this Friday. Here's a couple of assignments due this Friday. Here's one assignment due on this Friday, and so on. All the assignments are due on a Friday by 11:59 p.m. on that Friday. So that's the deadline for all of them, and you'll be penalized, like I just explained, if you're late. But this pace chart will show you everything you need to do. It has all the due dates for the entire quarter. So keep up with this and just stay on top of that. Now, what do I expect of you? Just do your assignments completely. Do good work, work on them hard, strive for excellence. And if you need help, you can ask me for help. You can ask other students for help. Don't ask other students to do your assignment for you. Don't copy their assignment. I can tell when you copy somebody's assignment. But if you're not sure how to do something, ask somebody else. I've got resources posted in Schoology. You can go on Google and search for help. Do any of these things that you would like to. Most of all, pray for one another and talk to one another about how to do these things. So, I'm looking forward to this class with you. I hope you will enjoy it. I hope you will learn a lot from it. And again, please be sure and let me know if you have any questions.